The Minutemen are on a roll. I helped that settlement you sent me to, and cleared the way for a new settlement in the process.
That's fantastic news. We're gonna take back the whole Commonwealth from the bad guys at this rate. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Your energy is tied to this place.
We used to live here. A long time ago.
Ah, but the distant past ain't so distant for you. I saw you leave that icebox. This whole world is like some bad dream you can't wake up from, isn't it? The site can help you, kid. It always has answers. Just gotta bring me some jet so I can see what it wants to tell you.
What's jet?
It's a little inhaler that packs a big kick. They say it makes you move faster, but at my age, it's more of a quick rush. The chems fuel the site, so it's not always gonna be jet I'm asking for. But that's what's on the menu this time.
Maybe. Let me think it over.
Well, ain't like I'm going anywhere. The site will be here when you need it.
I need to assign someone to this.
Nothing to report at the moment. Stay tuned for updates.
Hey there.
Ah, gosh darn, it's good to see artillery here again. Now here's the thing about the big guns. They can't fire at anything too close. Their range is impressive. That's what they're smoke grenades. Plus one of those is bad guns. We have artillery and range. But first, we better do a test fire. Make sure we're hitting what we're aiming at. You see that little building over there? We'll use that for our aiming point. Keep your radio on and tuned to Radio Freedom so we can confirm we're ready.
Wisely, General.
gotta hand it to you, General. You've really turned things around for the Minutemen. I never thought I'd see the day that the Minutemen had artillery support again. We should see about building them at all our settlements to expand our coverage. And Ronnie Shaw returns. She's something else, isn't she?
Yeah, she definitely knows how to take charge.
Ha, that's a bit of an understatement from what I hear. I'd heard stories about her from the old-timers, but I didn't know she was still around. The fact that she's come back to the Minutemen means we must be doing something right. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Hope you ain't one of them scents here to spy on me.
You're with the Minutemen, right?
What seems to be the problem?
A pack of feral ghouls has holed up nearby. And some of them have started wandering out lately. If more of them start wandering out this way, we may be overrun. We need someone to clear them out.
Are ghouls a common problem?
Yeah. There never seems to be an end to them. Guess there must have been a lot more people before the bombs dropped.
I'll have a look, but I can't promise anything.
Well, that's all I can really expect.
Oh, sorry. Thought you might be one of those forged maniacs, but you don't have the burns. A group of them took over the old ironworks, and they'll shoot you just as soon as look at you.
I'm with the Minutemen. Tell me what happened, and maybe I can help.
Well, I'll be jiggered. Didn't really expect anybody to come. That bastard son of mine, Jake, snuck out in the middle of the night to join them. He grabbed my granddad's old sword. It's the closest thing I've got to an heirloom. If you really are with the Minutemen, and you want to help, well, it would mean a lot to me if you could get that sword back.
I'll find it.
You're doing me a big favor, and I'll make it up to you as best as I can. You aren't gonna find my granddad's sword just standing around.
someone there.
Thank you.
tries to leave, kill him. You must be pretty strong to make it here.
Who are you supposed to be?
I'm Slag, and we are the Forged. And you, stranger, you're somebody with some guts. I like that. See, Jake? Here's someone who might actually be worth my time. Unlike you.
But you're gonna kill me.
But I brought everything you asked for.
Stealing things from your family farm doesn't prove your strength, boy. Though this wonderful sword you brought does put me in the mood to give you one last chance to prove your worth. What do you say? Kill that prisoner and prove that you aren't completely useless.
You said we'd be raiding outside the Commonwealth. These people aren't even a threat to us.
Prove to me that you can kill! It's him or you.
Oh God, what do I do? What do I do?
I've got places to be.
Please, let me go.
I just wanted to provide for my family. I don't know if I can do this.
Last chance, Jake. You don't kill
this place is just full of charm, isn't it?
It's over.
Rubbish where you found it.
Terminal somewhere.
Here goes nothing.
What the? Boy, I told you that
Abraham,
if you ever showed your face
on?
Here again, I...
Is that my boy come home?
What? Jake's back? Oh, thank God. Papa, please. I know I screwed up pretty big.
I thought if I joined up, I could keep them from raiding our farm.
I didn't. I don't want to hurt anybody.
I don't care what you thought. I told you.
Abraham Francis Finch, that's enough.
Mama, if...
Shut up, Jake. If I hear anything out of either of you, you'll both be peeling potatoes for the next year. I've watched you two go at it for years and tried to let you sort it out for yourselves. Abraham, your son is a grown man. And if you expect him to act like one, then you'd better stop treating him like a child. Jake, your father and I have been out there, and we know it can be dangerous. We just want to make sure you're prepared. There, it's over. And if I hear another word about it from either of you, so help me. Huh?
Hi.
She's right. I've been a fool. There's no way I can thank you enough. Here's the caps we agreed on. Plus a bit for helping my boy. I think you should hang on to that sword. It'd put a smile on Granddad's face to know it was being used to help you.
Sir, a moment, perhaps?
Sure, Codsworth. What's up?
Oh, just a little something I'd like to get off the old proverbial chest. I just want to say what an honor it is for me to accompany you. You've no idea the horror these past two centuries have wrought. The initial destruction. Not knowing if you and your family were all right. It was a relief just to find the entrance intact.
I'm sorry, Codsworth. It was so sudden. Not even time for goodbyes.
Not a single worry, sir, as I shared your priorities completely. Family safety first, above all else. And yes, while it was hard at first, I was able to eventually move on. At first, it was the work, busying myself day and night, and believe me, there was plenty of it. But eventually, the work became light chores. What truly saved me was my memories, sir. Memories of you and the missus, young Sean, of your love and kindness. I soldiered on, fueled by hope that one day, if not you and the wife, that Sean, or perhaps Sean's children, would one day emerge.
You don't regret it? All the waiting?
Never. If you ask me, it was worth it. All 200 years. I just wanted you to know how much I consider you family. I may be a mere robot to some, but I do hope you've come to see me as more.
I consider you to be family too, Codsworth. We're in this world for the long haul. Together.
Mr. Gabriel, you don't know how wonderful it is for me to hear that. I feel completely recharged. Well, enough blither-blather from me. Let's get back to it, shall we?
You're welcome around my farm anytime, friend.